പ്രാർത്ഥനയ്ക്കായിട്ട് നമുക്ക് ഒരുങ്ങാം. ദൈവമായ കർത്താവേ, ഈ അനുഗ്രഹ സമ്പത്തിനായിട്ട് സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു. പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് ഈ ദിവസം പ്രഭാതത്തിൽ പ്രത്യേകമായിട്ട് കർത്താവേ ജോസഫ് മാർത്തോമാ മെട്രോപൊളിറ്റൻ തിരുമേനി ഓർക്കുന്ന ഏറ്റവും അനുഗ്രഹപ്പെട്ട ദിവസമാണ് കർത്താവേ. 30 വർഷക്കാലം ജീവിച്ച കാലങ്ങളൊക്കെ ഓർക്കുന്നു. ദൈവമേ, ദൈവത്തിന് സ്തുതി കരയേറ്റുവാനായിട്ടൊക്കെ അനുഗ്രഹിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവേ. പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് മാർത്തോമാ സഭയെയും മറ്റു ബിഷപ്പുമാരെയും അച്ഛന്മാരെയും ശുശ്രൂഷകരെയും സ്ത്രീകളെയും കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങളെയൊക്കെ ഓർക്കുന്നു. ദൈവമേ, എല്ലാ അനുഗ്രഹങ്ങളും ദൈവത്തിന് ദാനമായി കാണുന്നു. ദൈവമേ, കേരളത്തിൽ മാത്രമല്ല ഇന്ത്യയിൽ ലോകത്തെമ്പാടും പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് തിരുമേനിയുടെ ജീവിതത്തെ ഓർക്കുന്നു. ആലക്കങ്ങളിലൊക്കെ ദൈവമേ സഹായിച്ചു. പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് ഈ കാലഘട്ടങ്ങളിൽ അഭിവീക്ഷിക്കുന്ന സന്നിധിയിലൊക്കെയും ദൈവമേ, ദൈവത്തിൽ നിന്നൊക്കെയും ആശ്വാസം നൽകണമേ. പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് ഇന്ന് പങ്കെടുക്കുന്ന എല്ലാവരെയും ഓർത്ത് സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു. ഇന്ന് ഈ സ്ഥലത്ത് ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് കുറെ ആളുകളാണെങ്കിലും ദേശം ആളുകൾ ഓർക്കുവാനും ദൈവത്തിന് കരയേറ്റുവാനും ഇടയാകുന്ന കർത്താവേ, ദൈവത്തിന് ധാരാളമായ കൃപ എപ്പോഴും നൽകണമേ. വീണ്ടും ഒരിക്കൽ കൂടെ ഞങ്ങളുടെ തിരുമേനിക്ക് വേണ്ടി പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവേ. ഇനിയും ദീർഘവർഷങ്ങളെ ജീവിതത്താൽ അവിടുത്തെ ആത്മാവിൽ നിറയ്ക്കപ്പെടണമേ. ദൈവത്തിന്റെ കാവൽ കൊടുക്കണമേ കർത്താവേ. രാജ്യത്തോടെയും സഭയുടെയും സമൂഹത്തിന്റെയും ആത്മീകമായിട്ടുള്ള കാലങ്ങൾക്ക് വേണ്ടി ദൈവം കൊടുക്കുന്ന അനുഗ്രഹമാകുവാൻ തുടർന്നെടുക്കണമേ. പങ്കെടുക്കുന്ന എല്ലാവർക്കായിട്ട് സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു. ഇന്ത്യയെ രാജ്യത്തും എല്ലാവരെയും ഓർത്ത് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവേ. ദൈവത്തിന് മാത്രം സന്തോഷത്തോട് കൃപയോട് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. യേശു പോലും ഞങ്ങളുടെ പ്രാർത്ഥന കേൾക്കണമേ.
താങ്ക് യു തിരുമേനി. ഐ കോർഡിയലി ഇൻവൈറ്റ് ദ മാർത്തോമാ സഭാ സെക്രട്ടറി Reverend K.G. Joseph for the welcome address.
Honorable Prime Minister of India, Sri Narendra Modi ji, the known Ajmerian and the spotlight of today's occasion, His Grace the Most Reverend Dr. Joseph Mar-Thoma Metropolitan, respected bishops, other dignitaries and spiritual leaders, representatives of the church, distinguished invitees and well-wishers. The 90th birthday of our most respected Metropolitan Tirumeni falls today. It was his desire that the occasion be dedicated to the upliftment of the weaker section of the society, irrespective of caste, creed or any religion. It is keeping that solemn commitment that we have launched the Snehagaram and other humanitarian projects. We are also to witness the inauguration of the Joseph Mar-Thoma Navadi Center to accommodate the headquarters of the church, which will ensure speedy and effective implementation of our social projects for humanity. We wish you, beloved Tirumeni, a very meaningful birthday greetings and thank God Almighty for your presence and unflinching leadership in the most trying period of the era. What is most humbling is the fact that despite a very short notice and amidst the most trying times, both in terms of the corona pandemic as well as the situations with the neighboring countries, our beloved Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji has taken out time for participating and blessing the Navadi celebrations and the many social welfare programs linked to the Navadi celebrations. It greatly displays his humility and affection towards our church and its members, and as we reciprocate by assuring the Prime Minister that we too shall always rise up to the demands of the citizens of this great country, which you head. Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji, sir, the entire Mar-Thoma community across the globe extends a warm welcome to this auspicious occasion. The Chief Minister of Kerala, Sri Pinarayi Vijayan, has always wholeheartedly supported us at all times. The church acknowledges your support and extends a warm welcome to you, sir. We are also equally grateful to the Honorable Governor of Mizoram, Sri Sridharan Pillai, for making this celebration a reality. Our sincere gratitude and warm welcome to you, sir. We greatly acknowledge the presence of the former Deputy Speaker of the Rajya Sabha, Professor P.J. Kurian, respected Member of the Parliament, Sri Andrew Anthony, Mr. Matthew T. Thomas, MLA, the Principal Secretary of Higher Education, Dr. Usha Titus, the District Collector, Sri P.V. Nuh, respected Bishops, especially Moron Mor Vesalius, Cardinal Flemis Tirmeni, Dr. Johannan Mar Chrysostomus, Metropolitan Tirmeni, Dr. Joseph Mar Gregorius, Metropolitan Tirmeni, Bishop Thomas K. Umen Tirmeni, Giveris Mar Theodosius Tirmeni, and all other bishops, and Sri Akirvan Patadiripad. And well-regarded spiritual leaders, distinguished dignitaries of the government, local leaders, representatives of the church, and well-wishers. I would also like to place on record our thanks and welcome to the various social media platforms and other media houses that keep us well connected despite all odds. I pray to God Almighty to continue to bless and strengthen us all to reach out to the multitude with a helping hand. May this be a blessed and memorable event for all of us. God bless this nation and God bless all of us. Thank you.
Thank you, Achin. We move on to the defining moment of the day. This private celebration is being transformed to an event of national significance, more so as it is done by none other than the head of the government of India. With due respect and immense joy, we humbly invite the Honorable Prime Minister of India, Sri Narendra Modi, sir, to deliver the inaugural address, thereby initiating the start of all humanitarian projects envisaged through the 90th birthday celebrations of our metropolitan.
Honorable Reverend Dr. Joseph Mar Thoma, Metropolitan, revered fathers, distinguished members of Mar Thoma Church, it is my great privilege to address this august gathering. We have gathered to mark the special occasion of the 19th birthday of most revered Dr. Joseph Mar Thoma, Metropolitan. I convey my greetings to him and I wish him a long life and best health. Dr. Joseph Mar Thoma had devoted his life for the betterment of our society and nation. He has been particularly passionate about removal of poverty and women empowerment. Friends, the Mar Thoma Church is closely linked with the noble ideas of Saint Thomas, the Apostle of Lord Christ. India has always been open to spiritual influence from many sources. The contribution of Saint Thomas and following him the Indian Christian community are deeply valued. With Saint Thomas, we associate humility. He rightly said, and quote, humility, which is a virtue, is always fruitful in good works, unquote. It is with this spirit of humility that the Mar Thoma Church has worked to bring a positive difference in the lives of our fellow Indians. They have done, and they have done so in areas such as healthcare and education. Saint Thomas was blessed with immense wisdom. The Mar Thoma Church played a role in India's freedom struggle. The church was at the forefront of working towards national integration. This church fought the emergency. It is a matter of immense pride that the Mar Thoma Church is firmly rooted in Indian values. The contribution of the church has also been recognized at the national level. The former Metropolitan of Mar Thoma Church, Philippos Mark Chrysostom, was confirmed with the Padma Bhushan in 2018. He inspires many. Friends, the world is fighting a strong battle against a global pandemic. COVID-19 is not only a physical sickness that is a threat to lives of people. It also takes our attention to unhealthy lifestyles. A global pandemic implies that humanity as a whole needs healing. Let us do everything possible to further harmony and happiness in our planet. Friends, you would be happy to know that, powered by our corona warriors, India is firmly fighting COVID-19. Earlier this year, some people had predicted that the impact of the virus in India would be very, very severe. But due to lockdown and many initiatives taken by the government, as well as a people-driven fight, India is a much better place than many other nations. India's recovery rate is rising. Any loss of life is unfortunate due to COVID or otherwise. However, India's death per million due to COVID is under 12. To place this in a context, the death rate in Italy is 574 per million. The figures in America, Britain, Spain, and France are also much higher than India. Lakhs of villages, home to 85 crore people, remain almost untouched by coronavirus. Friends, a people-driven fight has given good results so far. But can we let our guard down? No, not at all. In fact, we have to be even more careful now, wearing masks, social distancing, 2 gaj ki duri, avoiding crowded places, regular hand washing. These remains important. At the same time, we have to focus on economic growth and prosperity for 130 crore Indians. The wheels of trade and commerce have to move. Agriculture has to flourish. In the last few weeks, the government of India has addressed both short-term and long-term issues relating to the economy. From the sea to space, from the farms to the factories, people-friendly and growth-friendly decisions have been taken. The call for Atmanirbhar Bharat, self-reliant India, will ensure economic strength and prosperity for every Indian. A month ago, the Union Cabinet cleared the Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana. This scheme is going to transform our fisheries sector. With an investment of over rupees 20,000 crore, this scheme seeks to boost the sector. The aim is to also increase export earning and provide more employment to over 55 lakh people. We want to ensure better technology, infrastructure, and making value chain stronger. I am confident my fishermen, sisters and brothers in Kerala will gain from this scheme. Friends, historic reforms have been undertaken in the space sector. These reforms will ensure greater use of space assets and activities. Access to data and technology will improve. I see several youngsters in Kerala, and particularly in South India, taking a keen interest in science and technology. They will gain from the reforms. Friends, our government has always been guided by sensitivity and a long-term vision to make India a growth engine. We have taken decisions not from comfortable government office in Delhi, but after feedback from people of the ground. It is this spirit that ensured every Indian has access to a bank account. Over 8 crore families have access to smoke-free kitchens. Over 1.5 crore houses have been made to give shelter to the homeless. India is home to the largest healthcare scheme in the world, Ayushman Bharat. over a crore people have got quality treatment. For the poor, we are bringing one nation, one ration card scheme to help them where they are. For the middle class, we have brought a number of initiatives to boost ease of living. For farmers, we have increased the MSP and made sure they get the right price. And we are making the sector free from middlemen. For women, we are ensuring that their health care gets due attention via various schemes, and their career path is not compromised by ensuring extension of maternity leaves. The government of India does not discriminate between faith, gender, caste, creed, or language. We are guided by the desire to empower 130 crore Indians, and our guiding light is the Constitution of India. Friends, the Holy Bible talks extensively about togetherness. Now is the time to join ranks, work together for the advancement of our nation. Think of this: how can our actions contribute to national development? Today, India is saying we will produce locally and also buy local products. This will light the lamp of prosperity in the homes of many. There are many ways to strengthen our nation. The Mar Thoma Church, in line with its values, will surely rise to the occasion and play a key role in India's growth trajectory in the times to come. Once again, I convey my greetings to Honorable Reverend Dr. Joseph Mar Thoma Metropolitan. Thank you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji, from the depths of our heart, for sharing your dream of a better India and for making the special function of the church a memorable one. The man of the moment and the vibrant voice of the church, His Grace, the Most Reverend Dr. Joseph Mar Thoma Metropolitan, will share with us the quintessence of